Good morning. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the test. Again, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Khaldun Azari. I'm the president of this club, and I have the honor to have you today along with Mr. Ichiro Matsui, the governor of Osaka Prefecture. He's going to talk today about the theme of Osaka ready to host 2025 World Expo in Japan. And he told me at the anteroom it's a different type of World Expo, and it's their own idea. And it will be kind of promoted today by his explanation about it. Also, I would like to say that Governor Matsui is also leader of a political party in Japan. It's a well-known party, Nippon Ishin, and it has Nippon Ishin Nokai, and it has it has 27 members in the both houses in the parliament. And today we will hear a lot about political issues along with the expo explanation and promotion. And without further ado, please, ladies and gentlemen, welcome Governor Matsui today. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
We would like to thank the members of the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan for providing us with this wonderful opportunity to speak here.
本日私が皆さんにお伝えしたいことは3つあります。
There are three things which I would like to convey to everybody here today.
1つ目は大阪の魅力について。大阪はチャレンジ精神旺盛で、今面白いことや楽しいことがたくさん起こっているということをお伝えをいたします。
The first thing which I wish to convey is about the charms of Osaka. Osaka is a place where there is plenty of challenging spirit, and so I would like to convey to you the fact that many very interesting and enjoyable things are happening there.
2つ目は2025年日本万博博覧会について2025年にの万博にかける私の思いや日本が目指す万博の姿などをお話をいたします。
The second subject which I would like to talk about is in regard to the World Expo 2025 in Japan. And in regard to the 2025 Expo event, I would like to convey to you my feelings about this subject as well as what we are striving to achieve in expos here in Japan.
3つ目は大阪の未来についてです。
The third subject which I would like to talk about is in regard to the future of Osaka.
まずは大阪の魅力からお話をいたします。
First of all, I would like to start off by talking about the charms of Osaka.
大阪は関西と呼ばれるそのエリアにありまして、西日本の中心地であります。
Osaka is located in a region called Kansai in Japan and is the center of Western Japan.
歴史的にもアジアの玄関口、外国の先進的な文化や制度の入り口としての役割を果たしてきました。
Historically speaking, Osaka has served as the gateway to Asia and many of the leading ideas and systems of theWestern, the foreign culture have used Osaka as the entry point.
大阪人は昔から新しいことにチャレンジをしてきました。
The people of Osaka have for a long time continued to challenge new things.
大阪の企業はたくさんの世界初を生み出しています。
and corporations in Osaka have created many things which were the first of their kind in the world.
例えば、カップヌードル、インスタントラーメン、回転寿司などは大阪が発祥の地です。
For example, cup noodles, instant ramen, and 回転寿司 or conveyor belt sushi restaurants all originated in Osaka.
ものづくりにおいても大阪は伝統があります。
In the area of monozukuri or craftsmanship production, Osaka has a long tradition.
世界初の電卓は1964年に大阪で誕生をいたしました。
The first compact pocket calculator in the world was created in Osaka in 1964.
刃先を折ることができるこのカッターナイフも大阪が発祥の地であります。
And this kind of utility knife whereby it is possible to bend off the tip of the blade was something that originated in Osaka.
自動改札機は高度経済成長期において駅の混雑を解消するために発明をされました。
Furthermore, the automated ticketing vending machines were invented to alleviate the situation of congestion in the stations during the period of high economic growth here in Japan.
創業100年を迎える大手の家電メーカーパナソニックも大阪の企業です。
Furthermore, the major home appliance manufacturer Panasonic, which has reached its 100th anniversary since the establishment of the company, is also an Osaka company.
また、大阪の中小企業は世界に誇る技術力を有しています。新幹線にも使用されている緩まないネジ、JAXA にも納入する超精密バブルなどは大阪発です。
And furthermore, the small and medium enterprises of Osaka have technical capabilities which are world class. For example, in the Shinkansen bullet train, there are the hard lock nuts that are provided, as well as the ultra high precision valves that are provided to JAXA, which all originate from Osaka.
大阪では伝統にも新しい風を吹き込む取り組みも行ってきました。
Furthermore, there have been efforts made in Osaka to bring new trends into tradition.
大阪の象徴でもある大阪城もご覧のように 3D マッピングで彩りました。
For example, a symbol of Osaka is the Osaka Castle, and as you can see here, the 3D mapping has been used as a technology to decorate it.
これだけの巨大な建造物に 3D マッピングを行うことで話題になりました。海外からの観光客の方々も喜んで写真を撮られておりました。
And when it comes to a building of this large size, the fact that 3D mapping was used on this building was something that created quite a lot of attention to it. And from overseas, many tourists have come to take pictures happily of this.
こちらはモトクロスの世界大会を大阪城で行った時の写真です。
This is a photograph of when a motocross world event was carried out in the grounds of the Osaka Castle.
大阪城でオートバイを走らせるなど、荒唐無稽と国から言われましたが、実現をさせました。
We were told by the national government but that it was a ridiculous idea to have motorcycles run through the grounds of the Osaka Castle, but we have been somehow able to realize this.
世界中にこの大阪城が発信をされ、皆さんに知っていただくいい機会になったと思います。
This provided us with a very good opportunity to have people throughout the world become aware of Osaka Castle.
ちょっといいですか。これ日本でこのオートバイの大会をやったのは大阪だけです。
And for this motorcycle event here in Japan, Osaka is the only location whereby such an event was ever held.
こちらは大阪のメインストリート、御堂筋です。
Over here we see the main street of Osaka, 御堂筋。
大阪の大動脈でもあり、 最も交通量の多い道路の一つでありますまたイチョウ並木でも有名です
And、this acts as the main artery for Osaka and is one of the roads that have the most、amount of traffic Furthermore, it is famous for the row of ginkgo trees
その、御堂筋をサーキットに見立てまして、F1 のフェラーリを走らせましてたくさんの方に喜んでいただきました。
And、the Omidosuji was set up as a circuit, and an F1 Ferrari racing car drove through the street, and many people were very happy to see this.
文化の面でも新しい取り組みを行ってきました。
Furthermore, in the area of culture, many new efforts were carried out in Osaka.
大阪カンバス推進事業は大阪の街をカンバスに見立てましていろんなアーティストに活躍をしてもらう試みです
The Osaka Canvas Project was、set up so that the town of Osaka could act as if it were a canvas of art and many different artists participated in this attempt
この大きなこけしは高さ13メートルに及びます周りの高層ビルにも負けない、存在感で話題となりました
And this very large wooden kokeshi doll is of 13 meters height, and it is, has a strong sense of presence that is in no way inferior to the high-rise buildings around it. And this created quite a lot of sensation.
大阪カンバスは毎年大阪の各所で行っております。ぜひ皆さんにも取材に来ていただきたいと思います。
The Osaka Canvas Project is held each year in various locations in Osaka, and we hope that the people here will take the opportunity to cover the event.
大阪は食い倒れの街としても有名です。
Osaka is also famous as a place where people spend much of their money on food.
和食はユネスコの無形文化財にも登録をされ、世界から注目される食文化です。
Indeed, the Japanese cuisine has been registered as a UNESCO intangible cultural asset and is a culture of cuisine that has been attracting attention from throughout the world.
和食の味を決めるのは、決め手となるのは出汁でありまして、大阪が発祥です。
And one of the determining factors of Japanese cuisine is the dashi or the soup stock, and this also originated from Osaka.
日本が世界に誇るユネスコ無形文化財、ユネスコ無形文化遺産、人形浄瑠璃の文楽も大阪の魅力の一つです。
And furthermore, another UNESCO intangible asset, of culture is the Jōruri, which, is what the pride of, Japan. And this was also one of the, this is also one of the charms of Osaka.
こうした魅力が海外の皆さんにも浸透をしてきました。
And these charms have become widely known from people from abroad.
それを裏付けるのがこの、あのグラフでありまして、私が知事に就任した、2011年、2011年は158万人のインバウンドのお客様でしたが、2016年には941万人と6倍にまで伸びてまいりました。
And as evidence of this, if you look at this chart, you can see that in 2011, when I became governor, the number of, inbound visitors totaled 1.58 million, whereas in 2016, this was increased by approximately six times to 9.41 million people.
今年1月にはニューヨークタイムズ紙で今年行くべき世界の都市2017にも選出をされました。
And this year in January, New York Times selected Osaka as one of the world cities that should be visited during 2017.
これまで大阪の魅力をについて、紹介をしてきましたが、皆さんにより分かりやすく魅力をお伝えするために動画を作成をいたしました。ご覧ください。
And I have talked about the charms of Osaka up until now, but in order for you to gain a better understanding of its charms, we have prepared a video, so we hope that you will enjoy it.
know Osaka?
この、 あのビデオに、ビデオの最後に映っていたのが1970年の大阪万博のシンボル、太陽の塔です。
At the end of the video that you just saw was the symbol of the 1970 Osaka Expo, the Tower of the Sun.
私もあの幼い頃に大阪万博に実際に行きましたが、あの熱気、活気というのはあの忘れられません。
And when I was a child, I went to visit the Osaka Expo at that time, and I still remember the excitement and vibrancy of that event.
それでは2025年日本万博博覧会について詳しくお話をいたします。
Now I would like to go into the details of the 2025 World Expo in Japan.
今月の11日に万博開催について閣議了解が得られ、正式に国のプロジェクトとなりました。
As of the 11th of this month, then the World Expo had the acknowledgement of the cabinet, so that this has become officially a national project.
私が万博を必要と考える理由は2つです。
And there are two reasons why I feel that this World Expo is necessary.
一つ目は、万博には圧倒的な求心力、発信力があるということです。
The first point is that World Expos have tremendous amount of appeal and the power to disseminate much information.
二つ目は、世界が抱える共通の課題に対して解決策を、日本なら提示できると思っているからです。
And the second point is because I feel that this affords us with an opportunity from Japan to propose solutions to common issues that are facing the world.
1970年の日本万博の焼き直しではなくて、新しい万博を提示したいと考えています。
And what we hope to achieve is not simply a rehash of the 1970 Expo event, but rather what we want to propose is a new kind of World Expo.
日本の成長を牽引するために必ず万博開催を実現させるという強い思いを持って取り組んでいきます。
And so we are now undertaking this with a very strong feeling that we definitely would like to realize this World Expo in order to promote the growth of Japan.
テーマは命輝く未来社会のデザインです。
The theme of the event shall be designing future society for our lives.
一人一人の命が輝く生き方と、それを可能にする社会、経済の未来像を参加者全員で共に描く場としたいと思います。
What we would like to achieve is to create a place whereby all the participants can get together so that we can propose lives which every individual will be able to shine. And we want to realize a society and an economy that will allow such an image of the future to be realized.
会場はベイエリアにある夢島です。万博を契機に夢島を日本経済成長の起爆剤にしたいと思います。
And the location would be the 夢島, which is located in the Bay Area. And we hope that taking the opportunity of the World Expo, 夢島 will act as a trigger for the growth of the economy in Japan.
来場者数は3000万人程度を見込んでいます。
And what we are anticipating is that the total number of visitors will be 30 million.
万博のアイデアは大きく3つあります。1つ目は待ち時間ゼロの万博です。
There are three major ideas which we will be pursuing for the World Expo, and the first one is zero waiting time.
AI 搭載のロボットが清掃、飲食販売、ガイド、来場者の荷物運搬などさまざまなサービスを担います。
Robots with AI functions will be carrying out a variety of different types of services, such as cleaning or the sales of drinks and the food and guiding people, and also taking care of the luggage that the visitors have.
例えば、ロボットが来場者に空いているパビリオンを紹介をしたり、ロボットによるパレードなどを提供します。
For example, the robots would be able to introduce to the visitors pavilions where there is very sparse participation, and also there will be parades by robots offered.
また、ドローンが荷物を運んでくれ、お土産などの荷物からの解放もされます。
Furthermore, drones will be able to transport luggage so that the visitors will be liberated from carrying around gifts and their own luggage by themselves.
さらに、パビリオンごとに事前に観覧予約を受け付けて、時間が近づくと来場者に知らせるシステムにより、待たない博覧会を実現したいと思います。
And furthermore, by having prior reservations made when the time is about to come where the visitor is reserved to attend a certain pavilion, there will be a system to notify the visitors of this so that we are hoping to realize through this zero waiting time.
次に世界各地から参加できる万博です。
And the next point is a World Expo where people can participate from throughout the world.
参加者同士が未来のライフスタイルや社会経済のシステムについて対話をすることが重要です。
It is going to be very important that dialogue is going to be realized among the participants about the future lifestyles, society, and the economy system, and the economic systems.
異なる価値観に触れて新たな気づきを得られる場にしたいと思います。
What we would like to offer is a place whereby people can be able to be in contact with different sense of values so that it will be possible to gain new insights.
参加者の発信を促し、出展者からの一方通行にならないようにします。
And we would like to urge the participants to be able to disseminate their own information so that it will not just be one-way communication from the exhibitors.
また会場に来ることのできない人に VR の技術などを使って実際に会場にいるような体験を提供します。
Furthermore, for people who are unable to come to the actual site, we would like to take advantage of virtual reality technologies so that they will be able to experience the expo as if they were at the actual site.
最後に健康になる万博です。
And then finally, we would like to offer an expo that will improve the health of the people.
来場者の行動パターンや食習慣をデータ化をし、個々に合ったライフスタイルを提案をします。
And taking advantage of the data gained from the behavioral patterns as well as the food diet of visitors, we would like to propose lifestyles that are suited for each individual.
また最先端のライフサイエンス技術も体験をしてもらいます。
Furthermore, the leading edge life science technologies would also be possible to experience there.
ワクワクと万博を楽しんでいただきながら、来場前よりも元気になって帰っていただける万博を目指します。
What we are striving to achieve is to have people come and be excited and enjoy themselves in the World Expo so that they will be much more reinvigorated than before they had come to the Expo.
iPS 細胞の研究でノーベル賞を受賞された山中教授も万博を応援をしていただいており、心強く思います。
And we feel very encouraged by the fact that Professor Yamanaka, who has received the Nobel Prize for his research on the iPS cells, has offered to support our efforts.
大阪関西には山中先生などの研究者や研究施設などのライフサイエンスに関する強みがあります。
One of the strengths of Osaka and the Kansai area as a whole is the fact that in regard to life sciences, there are many researchers such as Professor Yamanaka, as well as many research institutions in this field.
その強みを生かして世界に貢献をしたいと思っています。
So I feel that taking advantage of this strength, we should make a contribution to the world.
途上国では公衆衛生などの課題を抱えています。また今後アジアでは高齢化が加速されると予測をされます。
In the developing nations, they are facing public hygiene issues. Furthermore, in the future, it is anticipated that in Asia, the aging society will further accelerate.
世界で最も早く超高齢化社会に突入をした日本、関西から新たな技術やサービスを提供し、課題解決に貢献ができると考えています。
And since Japan is the first nation to become such an ultra-aging society, we hope that from Kansai it will be possible to propose new technologies and services so that we can make a contribution to solving problems.
健康関連産業は医療だけではなく、スポーツ、食、エンターテインメント、笑いなど広い裾野があります。
And in the area of the health-related industries, it's not just in medicine, but also in sports, in food, in entertainment, and in comedy. There is a wide base which we have.
こうした健康関連産業の振興により、2020年の東京オリンピック・パラリンピック後の日本の成長を牽引したいと思っています。
And so, by promoting these health-related industries, we hope that after the 2020 Tokyo Olympics and Paralympics, that we will be able to, promote the growth of the Japanese economy.
これから世界を舞台とした本格的な誘致活動が始まります。
Now, throughout the world, there is going to be full-fledged bidding activities for the World Expo that will begin.
ここからが、正念場です。
And from here onwards is going to be the crucial moment.
世界各国から多くの支持が得られるように、地元大阪府といたしましても、政府や、経済界、関西自治体と一体となって、全力で誘致活動に取り組みます。
And so,For the purpose of gaining as much support as possible from the various nations throughout the world, we would like to have the Osaka government work together with the national government, the economic circles, the other local governments of the Kansai area in being united so that we can do our utmost in carrying out this bidding activity.
さらに国内機運を盛り上げていきたいと思います。
Furthermore, we would like to build up excitement within Japan for this event.
すでに立候補しているパリは強力なライバルではありますが、2025年国際博覧会を必ずこの日本で実現するという覚悟を持って全力を尽くします。
And already, Paris is going to be a very strong rival to our efforts for this event. But we are going to work strongly with the determination to make sure that we can realize the Expo 2025 in Osaka.
最後に大阪の未来についてお話しします。
Finally, I would like to talk about my thoughts in regard to the future of Osaka.
日本が成長していくためには、東京一極では脆弱であります。
I believe that for Japan to continue to grow, we will be in a very vulnerable situation if there is excessive centralization in Tokyo alone.
大阪が東京とは異なる個性を発揮をして、東西の二極の一極として日本の発展を引っ張っていきたいと考えています。
We hope that Osaka will take advantage of its unique characteristics that are different from that of Tokyo in order to push forward the development of Japan by having two centers in both East and West Japan act as a single core.
そして将来的には 世界に存在感を示す都市、福祉と大阪を作りたいと思っています。
And furthermore, in the future, what we hope to do is to assert our presence by the creation of a sub-capital city of Osaka.
これから大阪は万博に向けてラグビーワールドカップやIR など世界的プロジェクトが連続をします。今年、来年が勝負の年だと考えています。
From here onwards, as Osaka is headed towards its efforts in realizing the World Expo, there is the Rugby World Cup, as well as the subject of IR, Integrated Resorts, and there are going to be a series of global scale projects. But what we feel is that this year and the next one will be the period when the things are going to be determined.
大阪の中心地梅田では新しい街づくりが進んでいます。緑が豊かでイノベーションが次々と起こる空間を目指しています。
In the center area of Osaka, Umeda, there are efforts to create a new urban development whereby the greenery is very abundant and in a place where innovation can take place consecutively.
大阪の顔として世界の方々に来ていただける街にしたいと思います。
What we would like to create is a town that acts as the face of Osaka, whereby people throughout the world will be encouraged to come.
さらに、リニア中央新幹線の大阪開通も最大で 8年間の前倒しが決まりました。
Furthermore, it has been decided that in regard to the linear central Shinkansen line, the opening of the Osaka services will be brought forward by a maximum of 8 years ahead of schedule.
リニアの開通により、東京と大阪が1時間で結ばれ、世界最大級の巨大都市圏が出来上がります。
And with the establishment of the linear service, this would mean that it would only be 1 hour between Tokyo and Osaka, thus creating one of the biggest urban blocks in the world.
こうした取り組みを通じて日本の成長を牽引をする福祉と大阪を目指したいと思っています。
And with these kind of efforts, we would like to strive to achieve the sub-capital status of Osaka that can push forward the growth of Japan.
これは私の部下であります、広報担当副知事のモズヤンです。
And this is my subordinate. It is the Lieutenant Governor Mozuyan that is in charge of public relations.
大阪の鳥であるモズをモチーフしたキャラクターです。
This character has as its motif the bird that symbolizes Osaka, the bull-headed shrike.
熊本県のくまモンとは友達でありますが、知名度が全く追いついていません。
And this character is a friend of Kumamon of Kumamoto Prefecture, but in terms of renown, this character is still not yet that well known.
大阪を PR をするために頑張っていますので、ぜひ皆さん取り上げてやってもらいたいと思います。
But this character is very active in promoting Osaka, and so I hope that the participants here will include this in their coverage.
ご清聴ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for your presentation. We had the governor of Kumamoto and he brought Kumo with him and we are hoping you bring your Lieutenant General Mozuyan with you today but hopefully next time.We'd like to open the floor to questions and answer. Please allow me to ask the first question today. What is there, are there any financial concerns about financing this expo in Osaka? And would you please enlighten us about this issue? Thank you.
財政上の懸念というのはありますでしょうか。その資金を確保するために何か課題となっている点というのはありますか。
大阪万博に対して、よく財源は大丈夫かという、お話があります。でも大阪万博の、開催のための、費用というのは、実際に万博をするために投資する費用というのは、まあ、1200億から1300億と言われてまして、その、を 国、我々地方の自治体、そして民間で3分の1ずつ案分をするということです。1300億っていうのはこのよく言われるんですけど、オリンピック競技場、国立競技場の、まあ、一つ分にも満たない、金額です。国と自治体とそして民間の皆さんであれば、その経費は十分賄えるものだと思ってます。
Well, often when there is talk about the Osaka Expo, a question arises as to whether there would be adequate financial resources for this event. But in order to hold the event, it is estimated that the investment required would total 120 billion yen or 130 billion yen. And if this is divided up one third each by the national government, us as the local government and the public and the private sector, then we believe that this amount of 130 billion yen compared to what it would cost for just the national stadium for the Olympics can fully be borne by the collaboration between the national government, the local government and the private sector.
Thank you.
Michael Penn of the Shingetsu News Agency. First, a short suggestion. Right now, there's a lot of interest in Yumeshima because of your bid for the Banpaku as well as the IR issue. You might consider allowing us to do a press tour of it at some point. My question relates, however, to politics. My question relates to politics. As you know, on July 2nd, there's going to be a Tokyo Assembly election here, Metropolitan Assembly election. And the current head of the Tomin Fasnokai is a man named Kazusa Noda, who's a former member of your party, who was a political candidate for several years. And the policies which he has put out seem very similar to the Osaka Restoration Association's policies. My question is, do you see the Tomin Fasnokai as a sort of brother organization, and do you see a possibility of federation on policy issues in the future? Thank you.
Osaka維新の会と彼の組織とあの連合を組むっていう可能性は何かございますでしょうか。今東京で非常にこう期待をされている、まあ、東京の政党、まあ、都民ファーストの会ですよね。この、 都民ファーストの会の、その政策において、まあ、大阪維新の会が、この大阪で実行してきた政策を実現してきたこととかぶっていることは理解をしています。ただ、それを本当に実行できる実現できるような組織、それから人材が、揃っているのかと言われれば、僕はちょっと都民ファーストの会というのは、現在の、その他の政党に所属している、まあ、一番は民主党に所属している人たちが、そちら側に移ったりですね、ちょっと、本気で、取り組めるような人たちが集まっているのかどうかというのは疑問です。我々はこの東京においてこの都議会選挙においては、我々独自の候補者を、擁立をして、日本維新の会の、として戦っていきたいとこう思ってます。
Right now in Tokyo, there are expectations towards this Tomin First Party. And in terms of the policies that they are citing, it is true that there is overlap, I understand, with those of the Osaka Restoration Association or the Osaka Ishin no Kai. But when we look at whether they are truly capable in their organization and in the human resources that they have, and when we consider the fact that the people in the Tomin First Party currently have people from other parties, such as the Democratic Party, that have transferred to this party, then there are doubts in my mind as to whether they are truly serious in this effort. And in Tokyo, therefore, for the forthcoming elections, we will be preparing from Nippon Ishin no Kai, or the Japan Restoration Association, our own candidates.
一番政策の違うところは、我々は早期に、豊洲市場を、この使うべきだと、築地から豊洲に市場を移転すべきだというふうな政策を掲げてます。
The biggest difference in the policies between the two organizations is that what we are calling for is a relocation from the Tsukiji market to the Toyosu market, and we believe that the Toyosu market should be utilized.
Thank you, Kagum.ノーボーダーの上杉隆と申します。知事お久しぶりです。
どうも、
大阪万博ワクワクするようなことなんですが、ちょっと有名な大阪に一つ抜けてるテーマがあるんじゃないかと、森友学園問題、
それは万博とは関係ないので、
世界的にはかなり有名なんですが、まあ、冗談はさておき、招致合戦も含めてその大阪に万博を持ってくる2025年に向けて、そのような負のイメージというのはやはり払拭するべきではないかと、知事はそのこの場所の FCCJ でも会見をされた籠池さんに対して、場合によっては刑事訴追、刑事訴訟も裁判もあり得るという発言をされています。また今の安倍総理の奥様ともお親しいということもあって、どうでしょうか、この大阪万博、きれいに招致をするために、きちんと、それをクリアにするということで、籠池さんを訴える、もしくは、国とも連携して、そのような形で、万博に向けて、整地するというようなお考えは、ないんでしょうか。
Yeah, my name is Takashi Uezuki, and I'm glad to see the governor. And although you have talked about the excitement of Osaka Expo, there is one point that has been missing in your presentation, and that which is a factor of Osaka, and that is the subject of the Moritomo Gakuen. And the governor stated at this point, this is not related to the subject of the Osaka Expo. However, in continuing the question, for the bidding for the 2025, there is this negative image because of this matter of Osaka, and so therefore it is necessary to try and clear up that situation. And Mr. Kagoike has been present here at the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan, and the governor has said the possibility of criminal prosecution of him, and since the governor is close to Prime Minister Abe in cleaning up this bit of business in regarding Mr. Kagoike, in order to hold the Osaka Expo, then are there any ideas as to having a collaboration with the national government in this area to clear up this matter?
まず、大阪万博と今回 の森友学園とは全くこうリンクしない話であります。
First of all, it must be mentioned that the subject of the Moritomo Gakuen is totally unlinked with the current matter of the Osaka Expo.
現在、森友学園の件につきましては、大阪府としてさまざまな調査をさせていただいております。昨日も、その調査を実施いたしました。
And currently in regard to the Moritomo Gakuen, the Osaka Prefectural Government is carrying out various types of investigation, and yesterday there was such an investigation that was carried out.
調査はまだ終了していません。途中経過は今日の新聞各紙でも出ているようなものです。
And the investigation is still incomplete, and the interim situation of that investigation is as what you can read in the newspapers today.
行政として、これはもうできる限り、調査を 調査をして、できる限りいろいろなこう問題点を解明をしていく。
And for the prefectural government, we would like to investigate as much as possible this matter and to elucidate the situation as much as possible.
我々行政には調査権はありません。捜査権はありません。
In carrying out the actual investigation itself, we at the prefectural government do not have the right for the actual investigation to be carried out.
先ほど、訴えるとかいう話がありましたけれども、まず我々がやらなければならないのは行政調査を最後まで、きちっとやるということです。
And, although it was mentioned about the idea of the bringing up the charges, what we must do on our side is to carry out the administrative side investigation.
その後のことは行政の調査の結果を見た上で判断をいたします。
And after that, what will happen will be determined by the results of the administrative activities.
総理官邸側への
Are there any points raised in regard to the Prime Minister's office?
総理官邸側との話ですが、これは森友学園の問題というのは2つありまして、1つが私学の認可のに対しての問題と、そして、森友学園に土地を売却をしたことに対しての、問題と、この2つの問題がありまして。
Now, in regard to the situation with the Prime Minister's office, there are two issues related to the Moritomo Gakuen. One is in regard to its authorization as a private school, and the other is in regard to the problem of the transfer of the land to Moritomo Gakuen. Those are the two problems.
土地売却は、国の国有地の売却ですから、この部分については、国の政府においてはっきり明快に明確に明確に説明をする責任があるとこう思ってます。
And in regard to the transfer of the land, and this is national land that was transferred, and so therefore it is the responsibility of the national government to clearly explain about this.
私学の認可の問題については大阪府といたしまして徹底調査をいたしました。そしてその結果についてはもう公表済みです。
And in regard to its approval as a private school for the Moritomo Gakuen, Osaka's responsibility is to carry out a thorough look into this, and already the results of this has been made public.
政府の問題と我々大阪府の問題はそれぞれ別ですんで、これは土地の売却については、政府で、徹底的に解明をすべきだと思ってます。
And it must be distinguished between the problems that must be carried, that must be looked at by the national government as opposed to those that must be looked upon by the Osaka prefectural government. And the matter of the land is that of the national government. And so therefore, it is their responsibility to thoroughly elucidate the situation.
Yes, please.One question, please.
ありがとうございます。ワシントンポストの小田由紀と申します。ワシントンポストです。
はい。
よろしくお願いします。
はい、お願いします。
日本国内で、こういった国際的なイベントを開催する前によく話題になるものの一つとして、タトゥーですとか入れ墨への扱いというのがあるんですけれども、大阪は、まあ、タトゥーの例えば調査をしたりですとか、司法違反とかで、堀市さんが取り締まりをされたりとして、裁判になったりとか、そういったこともあったりして厳しい態度を取ってるんじゃないかという印象を受けています。そこで、これに関連して質問なんですが、知事はこういった、例えばそのタトゥーや入れ墨も禁止ですとか、そういったその取り締まり等に賛同されるか、またこういった国際イベントをホストしようとしている状況で、よりタトゥー等が一般的になっているような状況、国際的な潮流に反している、矛盾している点というのはあるというふうにお考えでしょうか。またその堀市さんの裁判、表現の自由ですとか、タトゥーの文化の撲滅である等々という主張されているんですけれども、そういった後半、 どういうふうに、まあ、結果になってほしいか、何かこう希望お考えになることというのはありますでしょうか。お願いいたします。
no, when Japan holds international events of this nature, what comes up as a subject is the matter of tattoos. In Osaka, previously, there has been a very strong attitude in trying to prosecute people and also to take a very tough stance in regard to the aspect of tattoos. And so therefore, I would like to ask the governor whether what his thoughts are in regard to the ban on tattoos, or whether it is intention to enforce various rules in regard to tattoos. And we would like to ask about the fact that since there is a general acceptance that is seen more and more in regard to the subject of tattoos, what the stance would be in regard to an international event of this nature. And the second point I'd like to ask is in regard to the issues that has been cited of the elimination or the eradication of culture in events of this nature. And I would like to ask for the governor's thoughts in that.
まず申し上げたいのは、大阪において、入れ墨タトゥーを、一般の人に向けて規制しているわけではありません。大阪において公務員が入れ墨タトゥーをすることによって、その住民の皆さんに対して、威圧的な、形に、になっているという部分に対して公務員 の入れ墨、タトゥーを、規制をしている、禁止をしたということであります。日本ではやはり入れ墨タトゥーというものが、を寛容に認めるかという、そういう、風土というのはまだ、広がっておりません。したがって、公務員が入れ墨タトゥーをすることによって、市民の皆さんが、それに対して、非常に怖がるようなことは、これは避けていこうということで、橋本前市長が、大阪市 の職員において、職員に入れ墨タトゥーの規制をしたということであります。ただ、外国においては、入れ墨タトゥーというものは、まあ、表現の、自己表現のその自由というか、価値観の、個人の価値観の中に、染み込んでるというところもありますから、この入れ墨タトゥーを、これだけ海外からのお客さんも増えてますから、どういうふうな、海外からのお客さんは、まあ、そういう日本とそういう風習も違うわけですから、その人たちに、より日本を楽しんでもらうために、この入れ墨タトゥーをどういうふうにこれから対応していくのかっていうのは非常に、大切な話だとこう思っています。ただそれを、全て解放していくにはやはり日本人の理解を、進めていくということが重要だとこう思います。
First of all, it must be mentioned that in regard to Osaka, the irezumi or tattoos are not regulated for the general public. Rather, it is felt that tattoos on civil servants in Osaka may seem oppressive to residents, and so therefore there is a ban or there is a regulation against civil servants who have tattoos. And so here in Japan, the subject of the irezumi or tattoo is not yet widely tolerated in Japanese society. So it is felt that in order to avoid the feeling that civil servants are intimidating citizens, it has has been decided that under the previous governor, Mr. Hashimoto, that Osaka would regulate tattoos on civil servants in Osaka. And overseas, the subject of irezumi or tattoo may be considered as a form of self-expression and is dependent on the individual values of people, and so we have seen more greater acceptance. In regard to the fact that there are tattoos that are now being more generally accepted, we hope that it will be understood that we would like to have more foreign nationals come to Japan, but there are different customs here in Japan, but we hope that people will be able to come to Japan and enjoy themselves. And so therefore, it's going to be a very important subject as to what our response will be in regard to this matter. But in order to achieve the total liberation from any kind of regulations of this kind in regard to this subject, it is very important that there is understanding among the Japanese people on this matter.
One question, please.
あの在日オーストラリアニュージーランド商工会議所の名誉会頭となっておりますメラニーブロックです。本日は日本の政治でも森友学園でも入れ墨についての話ではないんですが、在日外国人がどのようにその大阪での万博の誘致についてお手伝いすることが可能なのかという、まあ、割と皆様にとっては軽い質問だということで後で批判される可能性が十分あるのではないかと思うんですが、やはり日本の良さを海外へのアピール、海外でのアピールをするのは日本の皆様ももちろんあれですけれども、なるべく我々も長い間日本にお世話になっている外国人としてはどのようにお手伝いすればいいかどうかということについて具体的なこと、まあ、その例えば万博誘致外国人手伝いなんとか支援会でも何でもいいんですけれども作りたいと思いますので、よろしくお願いします。
I am from the Chamber of Commerce Organization of New Zealand, and my question is not in regard to the Japanese politics or the Moritomo Gakuen or the matter of tattoo, but rather in regard to foreign nationals residing here in Japan and how we can be of help in this effort. And this may be light in substance compared to other questions, so that I might be subject to criticism afterwards, but in order for Japan to appeal its charms to people outside of Japan, it is not just the Japanese people, but perhaps a role can be played by us as foreign nationals residing here in Japan. And so therefore, perhaps one idea could be that there is a support organization by foreign residents of Japan to help in the effort of Expo.
大変ありがたい質問をいただいてありがとうございます。
I am very grateful for the question that was just presented now. Thank you.
ぜひ、在日外国人の皆さん方のでの、2025年、日本万博大阪開催、支援の団体というものを、作っていただきたいと。
And I hope definitely that there can be an organization established that will be carrying out activities to support the effort in 2025 for the holding of the World Expo in Osaka by the foreign residents here in Japan.
一番お願いしたいのは、ぜひ、友人、知人の皆さんに大阪の良さを知っていただくために一度、大阪に、旅行に行けばというそういう声を広げていただくのが一番かなと思います。
And the biggest request which I would like to ask of you is that perhaps you can suggest to friends and acquaintances to go on a trip to Osaka to become familiar with the city.
ありがとうございます。
And thank you indeed.
One more question.
Oh, okay.
This will be the last question today. Lady, are you a journalist? Okay, please come. Sorry. Because we have, The governor asked to end it sharp at 11:30, so he gave one more question. Sorry if you have no chance.
すみません、ザ・ページのスミーです。こんにちは。あの万博のことの、質問をさせていただきたいと思います。あの万博の、誘致までの構想からの期間があの非常にタイトだったと思います。それであの実際にこれからあのお話の中にもあったと思うんですが、あのライバルがパリとか他の国からも動きが出てくるかと思うんですが、これからあの実際に盛り上げていくための機運として国内世界あの具体的に考えていらっしゃることがあったら教えていただきたいのと、あとやはりあの夢島との開発のこともあると思うので、この2025誘致ぜひ実現したいということだったんですが、もしあのその実現に至らなかった場合、次の2030など考え今の段階でそこまで含めた構想でいらっしゃるのかどうか、その辺についてお聞きできたらと思うんですが、よろしくお願いいたします。
I would like to ask about the expo in light of the fact that it's going to be a very tight schedule for the bidding of the event, and you have mentioned in your presentation about the rival such as Paris, and I believe that there will be other cities that will also try to becomethe city for the expo. And so as you try to build up excitement within Japan as well as throughout the world, I would like to inquire about what specifically you are thinking about doing. And furthermore, as you carry out developments for Yumeshima for the 2025 event, if in the event that you are not able to be to have the event in 2025, what concept do you have, for example, such as in the future to try and achieve the event for 2030?Or so on.
まずあの2025年に向けて、日本この万博、誘致の準備期間が非常に短かったのじゃないかというあのお話はよくあります、よくいただきます。ただこれは短かったという捉え方とですね、あのスピード感を持って物事を進めているという2つの捉え方があると思います。僕はやはりあの今の時代において、その招致決定までの準備期間が2年半というのはこれだけ、もうあの情報通信 の, あのスピードが上がっている中で今の時代においてはまあ、あの適正な期間なんじゃないかと、これが あまりにも、こう急ぎすぎた時間が短いという、それはあの批判はちょっと当てはまらないんじゃないかなと、あのスピード感を持って、物事を進めてきているとい う僕はそういう捉え認識をしています。それと2025年、うん、あのもし、そういう、あの招致誘致をできなかった場合は2030年はどうなのという話ですけど、それはやっぱりその時の、責任者というか、知事や、その時の、総理だとか、要は政府が考えるべきことなので、僕は大阪府知事として僕の任期内、自分に与えられた時間内で2025年を目指したいとこう思ってます。
Now, in regard to the subject of the 2025 event, it has been heard by others about the fact that perhaps the preparation period is very short, but you could consider this as being a very short period of time to prepare for the event, or you could interpret this to mean that we are working with a sense of speed. And when we consider the current era right now, then to decide and to prepare for this in a period of 2.5 years,is in light of the fact that things are speeding up in this era of information communication technology, it may well be construed that this is an appropriate period. And so I do not believe that it is appropriate to consider that we are rushing things too much and that there is too little time for doing this, but rather I feel that we are doing this with a sense of speed. And in regard to the second question as to if we are not able to get the event for 2025 and what is the possibility for targeting 2030, I believe that those who are responsible at that time, such as the Osaka Prefectural Governor or the Prime Minister and the Japanese government, needs to consider it at that time. However, as the Prefectural Governor of Osaka, in my term of office, what I would like to concentrate upon is for targeting 2025.
Thank you very much, Governor Matsumi. This wraps up our event today. I would like to extend to you an honorary membership to our club for 1 year. Please come in and visit our facility.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Please remain seated until the governor leaves this room. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
どうして百条委員会の設置に反対したんですか。大阪府議会ですか。反対はしてません。まだその時期がじゃないでしょということです。あの時期にやっても百条委員会は意味なしません。まだまだ調査の結果が出てないんで、だから反対じゃなくて、もう少し物事の議論できる素材ができてからやればいいんじゃないのということで議会の判断になったということです。
将来は賛成されます。
今百条委員会やる必要ありますかね、大阪で。
あります。
もう大体ほぼ出揃いました。大阪府の報告書読みましたか。
読
んでもないのによく言えますね。これネットに出てますよ。一度報告書を読んでみてください、必要かどうか。
安倍総理はやめるべきだと思いますか。
全く思いません。
Please, could you please translate that? We'll have a translation for the English people.
The question was in regard to the Hyakujo Committee and why was it that the governor was opposed to the Hyakujo Committee, but the answer was that we were not opposed to it at all, but rather it is still too early and it is not necessary opposition, but rather it is necessary to carry out debate on this matter, and that the questioner should read the report on this matter about the Hyakujo Inkai. And the last question was in regard to whether it is felt by the governor that Prime Minister Abe should resign. And the reply was, I do not at all feel that he should resign.
Thank you, Funasaka-san, for your interpretation today, and I appreciate that.